No clapping. No, I'm just joking. Good morning. Welcome to church. Happy Easter once again. I'm glad you guys are here. We have a sweet, sweet presentation for you today, all about the resurrection of Christ, right? That's why we're here. And it says, I said this in the first service, it says the youth group play. After this morning, I think I'm going to take credit for that. Because I didn't know it was my play. I'm taking it, because it's good. And also, don't come tonight, because there's nothing going on here tonight. No classes at all, so please don't come. And if you are interested in baptisms, we are going to do a baptism service April 7th, Sunday, April 7th, after both services. So if you are interested in that or want to know more about baptism, please talk to Pastor Mark, and he will give you all the details. And the last thing I have for you, April 13th, if you were in college, or a 20-something, this is all for you. They are going to do a Mexican fiesta game night. Yes. Don't know what that looks like, but it's going to be awesome. So just to give you a heads up about that. You guys ready to pray? Let me pray. Take up our offering, get going. Lord, thank you for a great morning already. And just what I was thinking in Sunday school and what I'm thinking now is, Lord, I just don't want this to be a one-day celebration. I want us to remember you every single day of our lives about what you did for us, how great, how awesome it was. And Lord, you gave us salvation. You gave us hope. You gave us joy and peace. And we give it all back to you. Lord, we give you our lives 100%. Help us to commit ourselves to you. And Lord, this service, in every part, every way, we give it all to you. And we ask, Lord, touch our hearts again. In your name we pray. Amen.
Let's worship. work together for our good, and I can trust him. The Lord is a host, the Lord over all things, and there's a host of angels that he's Lord of. And you know what? The reason he has those angels is to help us. But, you know, I don't worship those angels. I worship the Lord God Almighty, the one who hung on the cross, who overcame death, who was risen, and he sits on the right hand of the Father. And you know what? He's out to help us and be our deliverer.
You are my morning song, the thunder stills the night. It cannot hide.
next song, it talks about a choice. And I just want to ask you, have you chosen Christ as your Savior? I did when I was a young person. Believe me, I was an absolute mess, and I needed help. And that's the best choice I've ever made. I've made a lot of mistakes in my life. And but the thing that I've done really right is when I ask Christ to be my Lord and Savior. He's held on to me. He's helped me. And there's no one like Him. It's not just an Easter story. It's not just religion. To me, it's everything. It's relationship with a God who loves me more than I can ever imagine. Lord, there's none like You. I choose You again. Thank you. choose you again and again and again. Lord, you're everything I ever wanted and more, God. Lord, my heart's desire is after you. Lord, I'm glad I finally made a choice that I was going to serve you, that I was going to love you, that I was going to follow you, and not just halfway, but Lord, that I give my life to you. Perfect I'm not, but God, my heart is after you. My heart is after you. And there's no one like you. Lord, I thank you for today and what it represents, God. It's the highest celebration we have because it's when you overcame death, Lord, to give us life. We could come to you, Lord, and Lord, make things right with you. Thank you for being all you are. You're everything to us. Bless this day in Jesus' name. Amen.
Come to the water, you who thirst, and your thirst no more. Come to the Father, you who work, and you'll work no more. And all you who labor in vain, and to the broken and shamed, love is
praise. Thank you for your son, Lord. There's no one else like him. Nobody else like him. We give you thanks and praise. Bless our day today, God. Just help us in every little way to minister to the folks that have come. God, just come present here with us in a powerful way. In Jesus' name, amen. A couple verses this morning. A couple verses. And it happened as they were greatly perplexed about this, they beheld two men standing by them in shining garments. Hey, they get to the tomb, he's not there, they go outside the tomb, they're scratching their heads, they're going, what in the world's going on? And two men with garments, shiny angel garments are standing there, and they go, huh? verse goes on to say, then, as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said to them, why do you seek the living among the dead? The big question this morning is, why are we looking for worldly dead stuff when we chase the one that's living? You all get that? Why are we looking amongst the dead for what's living? Why don't we look for Christ who's living, right? Because they were really confused. They thought they were going to find a dead Savior. They thought they were hopeless and in despair and nothing was going to work. But the news came, he's not dead. Next verse. He's not here. He is risen. He's not there. He's risen. He's not there. He's risen.
Wake up. The preacher's talking to you.
I'm awake. I was listening with my eyes closed. You're the one texting during the preaching. Who is this? I don't recognize this number.
You need to be listening to him.
Leave me alone.
It's Easter. I think you need this.
Hey, quiet. Stop texting during church.
I know this story. Jesus died and rose again.
That Jesus story is so amazing.
I don't even think I believe it. Well, I guess I believe he lived, died, and rose again. Even though that's weird, it's that I don't believe he died for me.
Not just for you, but for all.
Why would he care about me? I'm into Halo 4, Call of Duty, music, and my cell phone. Jesus can't even relate to that. He didn't do that for me.
Okay then, where are you going?
What do you mean?
Where are you going?
After church, to my girlfriend's house.
Where are you going in life or afterlife?
I don't know. Always wanted to be in the NBA.
No, really. What about eternity?
I don't know. I guess I don't even know about college yet.
You really don't know?
No.
It sounds like you're lost.
I'm not lost.
Then do you know where you're going?
I don't know.
If you don't know where you're going, you're lost.
Okay, I'm lost. Why is that so important to you?
It is very important to me. It is really important to Jesus.
Jesus stuff again?
You said Jesus couldn't relate to you.
That's right.
Matthew 18:11 says Jesus came to save those who are lost. I think that's you.
I have never ever thought about Jesus like that.
Now put up your phone and listen to me.
Who are you?
Just listen. I'm trying to keep you from being lost.
sin. Each time I come into your presence, I stand in wonder once again. Your grace still amazes me. Your love is still a mystery each day. I fall on my knees, 'cause your grace still amazes me.
I got one! I got one!
No way! They only had 10 at the store!
I know! I camped out for 72 hours, and now I own an iPhone 6 with Siri, voice recognition, high retina display, and 1 terabyte of memory. Heck, I can talk to my car!
That's incredible! What apps come on that phone?
They gave me $600 in free apps!
No one in Champaign County owns one of those.
Watch this. Siri, who's the coolest techie in Ohio?
Chad Reisinger, you are the coolest techie in not only Ohio, but in the world.
See? Even Siri knows how cool I am.
Hey guys, what's up?
Taking out the new iPhone 6?
No way! Yeah!
That's what I said about my iPhone 5.
And me about my iPhone 4.
Hate to tell you, but the iPhone 7's already displayed on the Apple website.
It can order pizza from your pocket, pay for it out of your account, have it delivered to your present GPS address, all without you even knowing it. It activates by hearing your stomach growl.
No way.
I love pizza, Jazz.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to bring you down.
Yeah, I guess you guys are right. You guys are right. This stuff doesn't make me cool. It only makes me think I'm cool for a little while. And then it gets old, and I want more. What a vicious cycle.
It's the way of the world, my friend. We want more, more, and more. It's never enough.
Remember that verse Pastor Nate taught us Wednesday night from 1 John 2? Don't love the world or the things of the world. Because anyone who loves the world does not have the love of the Father in them.
I guess you're right. I should have been listening. Instead, I was getting directions to the Apple Store. It would have saved me a bunch of time and money.
You're a lot like me, Techie. We need to focus less on what we want and more on what God wants for us.
I guess you're right.
Just a little secret. It's going to take more than the newest phone to make you two cool. But you're still pretty okay with me.
Whoever told you can't win? Whoever said that if you fail, don't try again? It's in the ordinary, deep in the weak and weary. You could be a hero. You could be a change in this world. Rise above the normal. Don't have to be afraid anymore. You are the light, you are the hope, you are the love inside worth fighting for. You could be, you could be, you could be a hero. Have to look that hard to see. You don't have to reach that hard to find someone in need. There's the desperation deep in this generation, looking for something new. You believe you could be a hero. You could be a change in this world. Rise above the normal. Don't have to be afraid anymore. You are the light, you are the hope, you are the love inside worth fighting for. You could be, you could be, you could be a hero. Love could heal, cry
across the ocean wide. Love will go to save a life, because the love God gave you will find you could be a hero. You could be a hero. You could be a hero. You could be a change in this world. Rise above the normal. Don't have to be afraid anymore. We are the light, we are the hope, we are the love inside worth fighting for. You could be, you could be, you could be a hero. You could be, you could be, you could be a hero.
Nice to meet you. Before we get started, I just want to remind you that this surgery is not 100%. Like, yeah, it's not guaranteed that
so
it's going to
like
work.
Like a guinea pig?
Kind of.
Oh, no.
Well, I'm willing to try anything and get my sight. I mean, just picture my mind, like, picturing faces in colors. It's not very good. And, like, I'm sure seeing would be way better than hearing and touching and tasting and smelling.
Percy, do you hear what this young nurse is telling you?
Yum.
This might not take. I'm afraid that you're getting your hopes and expectations too high, and then you'll feel let down.
Well, the doctor will be in here in just a minute, so why don't we go ahead and get some pre-surgery questions out of the way.
How many?
Oh, there's about 100 or so.
150.
All right, so Percy, what I need you to do is just answer each question truthfully and completely, and make sure that you're pretty loud because my young ears can't hear very, very well anymore. So, okay, are you ready? Here we go. Have you ever had allergies?
Nope.
High blood pressure?
Nope.
Chest pain?
Nope.
Trouble breathing?
Nope.
Had drug or alcohol problems?
Nope.
Better not.
Have you ever had belly pain? Belly danced.
Not successfully.
And it was cute.
Hey, have you had gas pain?
All the time.
Oh, boy.
High cholesterol?
Nah.
Trouble sleeping?
Nah.
Trouble eating?
Nope.
Never.
Okay. Trouble going to the restroom?
Nah.
Oh, no. She plugs that toilet up all the time. She can't see the damage she's done either.
You might not want to eat so much cheese, sweetie. Have you had trouble snoring?
No.
Have you ever had an earache?
Nope.
What was that?
No.
Okay, thank you. Have you lost feeling in your toes?
No.
Specifically the big ones?
No.
Okay. How about in your fingers, like the pinky or the thumb? No? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have you had back pain?
No.
Knee pain?
Mm-hmm.
Elbow pain?
No.
Finger pain?
No.
Have you eaten a triple from Wendy's with an extra large fry and a milkshake to go with that?
Obviously.
Okay. They're really good, aren't they? Have you had any nosebleeds?
Yep.
Have you ever taken prescription medications?
Yep.
Have you been on an airplane?
Nope.
What was that? No?
Yes.
Okay, no. Have you had a U.S. passport?
Nope.
Have you ever had a passport from another country?
No.
Why not? You should really go on a mission trip sometime. Anyway, have you had a concealed carry permit?
What's that?
Do you carry a gun?
Oh, yeah, but we don't tell my mom that.
Well, okay. Have you ever told a lie?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Jesus can help you with that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Have you kissed a boy?
No.
Have you had an ingrown toenail?
Yes.
Have you had surgery ever?
Mm.
Yes or no?
No.
No? Okay. Have you ever smoked anything that wasn't a cigarette? Have you?
No.
Okay,
no.
Thank you.
Open your ears.
Have you ever had a blind date?
Very funny.
Just kidding. Okay. Do you have a boyfriend?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Is he cute?
Ew, no.
How would you know that?
Because he sounds hideous.
Oh my god. Just a few more questions. Have you ever had whooping cough? You know the belly kind. That kind?
No.
No? Okay. Have you ever ridden a pony at the fair?
Nope.
Have you had shingles?
No.
Have you ever shingled a roof?
Yeah.
Hopefully you didn't fall off.
Yeah.
Have you ever been shot by a squirt gun?
Yeah.
Have you played with fire?
Yeah. We don't tell her about that either.
Yeah.
Have you had mental illness?
Every day.
Been on a safari?
That's her.
I will get to the mental problem or the mental questions here in just a second.
You can ask her, those are me.
You. Have you ever been on a safari, like where you see the giraffes and the
you
things
can't
like
see, so
oh,
no,
okay, sorry, I guess that's a no.
Here for eyes.
Forgot that. Have you spoken to a weird man at the bus station before?
Every day.
Every day. Have you gotten left and right mixed up ever? You know, there's
all
a,
the time.
You know.
Yeah, she can't tell.
I
she can't
don't know
left.
What you're trying to say.
Sorry. Okay. Have you ever eaten sushi? Yuck. Have you spoken Chinese?
I've tried.
Oh, yeah, me
not
too.
Not very fluent.
Not very good at it either. Have you had something ever stuck in your teeth? You know, like a...
Yeah, my times I want to say things for later.
Oh, okay. Have you ever sneezed and farted at the same time?
Oh, yes.
Do you
about
know?
Twice a day.
Yes.
It is a proven fact that people fart 14 times a day.
She's got a beach.
And then she's got me beat.
Okay, have you,
smelly house.
Have you ever spilled your milk? I hope not, but being blind, you just don't know.
She pours it for me and puts it in a sippy cup.
Have you ever milked a cow?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, Mike Morris knows how to milk a cow very well.
I bet he can do it blindfolded as well.
Hey, have you failed an eye exam?
Every time.
I've
every
never
time?
Failed an eye exam because I've never had to take one because I knew I was blind.
Are you blind?
I thought so. Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Okay. All right, last set of questions. Your full name? How old are you?
Percy Jackson.
Your age?
14.
Your occupation?
I'm a skydiver.
You're a student? Okay. No. Do you know your social security number or your locker combination?
My friends do.
Okay. Are you male or female?
I'm a male.
No, honey, you're female. Not what mommy told you.
Are you slave or freed?
I'm her slave.
Okay, that's good enough. Are you legally a citizen of this country?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Aren't I a slave?
You're good.
Do you know your street address?
No.
Mom, what's...
No, she doesn't know it either.
It's
no.
201 Crazy Avenue.
Okay, Crazy Avenue.
Hey!
Is that in Urbana? Christiansburg?
Christiansburg,
okay.
Why don't we tell everybody where I live?
What school do you attend?
Nurse over here is going to find
hey.
Me.
Graham? What school do you attend?
Graham.
Graham? Woo!
Yeah.
Go Falcons!
Go Falcons!
Woo! What's your mother's maiden name?
Wow.
That's me.
Your father's name?
Jason.
Okay. Do you have insurance?
No.
Are you sure?
We'll be on a payment plan, like $1 a week. Can we swing that?
Or cheap.
Yeah.
While I came here.
Yeah.
Okay. Got it. Do you have any pets at home?
Yeah.
Number of stairs in your house? Five more questions. These are mental stability
good.
Questions, the most important ones of my survey.
For you, Percy.
What are your expectations after surgery?
To see.
Is that all?
And to walk while I can see and not run into things.
Okay. Do you feel mentally stable?
Yeah.
How well do you deal with stress?
Not very
good.
No,
not good.
Do you think you could identify someone who is nuts?
My mom?
I do. didn't say I needed an example. I just said, could you identify? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. And what is your favorite nut? But you might not want to say plastic because those might hurt your teeth. Favorite nut? Peanut.
Pecan.
Yeah, me too.
At least that's what I'm told they are.
Oh, yeah. They're really good. All right. Well, that's the end of my questions. So the doctor should be coming here in just a second. Just hang tight. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
All right. Bye-bye.
Hi, I'm Dr. James.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
Hello, Dr. James.
Are we all ready to go?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right. Nurse, can I see the questions, please?
There you go.
All right. No chest pain, no allergies. Boyfriend, but he's ugly.
She thinks he is.
Real.
I know he is.
We might change that opinion.
Probably not.
Speaks Chinese. Ni hao ma?
Excuse me?
I just said hello in Chinese. You're doing great studying. Let me tell you.
I know. Level three.
The braille's a little difficult.
All right. Well, everything looks in order. Just to let you know, this procedure is probably going to take about 4 hours. There's about a 20% chance it's actually going to work since it's brand new. I promise this isn't my first time operating, just my second.
Oh, good.
Two's always the best.
Yeah, it is. I mean, we don't talk about the first time.
That's why I'm the second child.
Yeah. And even when if you do get your sight back, there's only a 1 in 2% chance you're actually going to be able to see again without glasses.
Well, I know deep down God will let me see.
And I'm just going to do all I can do.
And then God will do the rest.
And I believe he will.
All right, well, Mom, why don't you go ahead and stay over here? The waiting room is right around the corner. You might want to pray a little bit, you know. Percy, why don't you come with me? Watch your step right here. Step down.
God, I know you can do this. I know all things are possible through you. You will make my Percy see. Because you're alive.
Well, the surgery went very, very well. I'm really excited at the outcome. The doctor he got in there, he got everything situated, and he was very, very confident and happy that everything's going to be okay. So we'll know in a little bit.
So it's all well.
It is. We'll figure it out as soon as the patches come off of her eyes, and hopefully your prayers have been answered.
Of your emergency.
Diane?
Yeah.
This is Caitlin.
Yeah.
Bruce just got shot.
Are you serious? Where?
I'm serious. Bruce just got shot in the side.
Before he dies.
Bruce, talk to Mama.
Put him on the phone.
Hello?
Bruce?
Yeah.
Hey, I love you. Now listen. Okay. Jesus is going to take care of you, okay? You'll be saved. You just need to calm down and just focus on that, okay? Write it down on that wound, okay? Okay, honey, take a breath. Take a breath, okay? You can do this. You can do this, okay? You
put him puking, Mommy's puking.
Roll him on his side.
Roll on your side.
Roll him on his side and clean it out. Bruce? I love you, baby.
I love you.
Listen to me. Talk to Jesus. Talk to Jesus.
I am.
Ask him to save you and do it and just believe it, okay? Do you hear me?
I love you.
Dude, guess what?
What?
This random chick just sent me a request on Facebook.
What's she look like?
Well, she's blonde, cute. She said she's in college, dude.
Well, she's in college? Accept that request. Change your status from sophomore in high school to sophomore in college. She'll never know.
There you guys are. What? What are you guys doing at Build-A-Bear? Okay, whatever. I have important news to tell you guys.
Go away, Jordan. I'm looking up for my game to hear what you have to say.
Yeah, you decided to ditch us as friends when you posted that stupid video on YouTube all about your neighbor's goat that screams like a human.
Screaming girl, and both of you asked me to film it and put it online, and now you're both mad at me.
Once your video reached 1,000 views and everybody started talking about it, you treated us different. You only wanted to hang out with us if we get you more views and make you more popular.
But it did make me more popular. Well, than who I was before, when I was hanging out with you two losers. Well, but now, I mean, just think about it. What if I could reach 1 million views? Maybe MTV would make my life with the Screaming Goats a show. Or Verizon Wireless would make a $1 million ringtone. Or Nike would make shoes that every time you step, it'd make a little screaming goat noise. I'd be rich and famous.
Get over yourself. There's more to life than how many people watch your stupid little video.
I just think you're both jealous.
Nope, not jealous. Definitely don't want screaming goats at my feet.
Seriously? Jealous? No. People seeing your video won't help you graduate high school, college, or help you find a girlfriend. And eventually your video becomes history and no one remembers you or your video.
Yeah, but...
I'm not done. Yes, your video is funny, but how many people view your video doesn't make you a different person.
You're still the same, no different.
Man, what do they know? I mean, well, maybe they're right. What happens if I do reach 1 million views? Probably nothing. I'll probably be the same old Jordan. I should probably chase them down and say sorry.
Looking from the outside, outside, and I've been walking on a straight line, straight line. Scared to let the world see my failures, who I am, oh, who I've been. Maybe waiting for somebody else to take the chance that I'm so afraid to. I don't know how to find myself. Thank you. says, I want to feel you move me like a river running through me. I am so tired trying to prove it. I'm never gonna do it alone. Oh, I want to feel you move me like a river running through me.
My dad wants you to come in for a few minutes.
Really? He's not going to lecture me, is he?
Well, maybe. You did bring me home 5 minutes late last weekend.
He's not so mad about that, is he?
Come on, I'll help you.
Okay, but the movie starts in 20 minutes.
Then hurry up.
Hi, Mr. Wilson. Sorry I got Lindsay home late last weekend. I lost all track of my time.
You know, those details are very important to a father whose daughter's on a date.
I understand, sir.
Well, if you understand, don't let it happen again.
I promise it won't.
Well, since you were late last week, I want you home an hour earlier. I want you home by 11.
What? That's not fair.
But, sir, we can't go see a movie and eat by then.
But you can do it. Make sure you do it.
Yes, sir. You know, your dad doesn't trust me at all.
My dad doesn't trust me with any boy.
That's just wrong, though.
You just passed the movie theater road.
Let's go somewhere else tonight.
Then where are we going? I need to call my dad.
No, you're too worried about him. Let's make tonight a special night.
Let's go see a movie in Bell Fountain. That would be special. You're not going to Bell Fountain.
Well, actually, I know the spot where we can be all alone. And it's a pretty great spot to look up at the stars.
Well, the pastor at our church tells us that God made the stars.
Whatever.
My dad has a telescope. He could teach me about the stars, and we could just watch the stars at my house.
Well, where we're going, though, it's not really about the stars, you know? It's more about quality time. Just you and me all alone somewhere.
Alone? You know, I really am a very social person. I think it would be more fun if we called our friends.
Well, but we've never really been alone, though.
Being alone isn't all it's cracked up to be.
I thought you loved me.
I thought I did.
So you're one of those religious girls?
I was always taught that Jesus is watching.
Hey, hey, someone's following us. They're flashing their lights.
I didn't know there was a movie theater way out here. Maybe you should come with me.
I think so, too. Give me my phone. I'm deleting your number.
Are you all right?
How did you know?
The father always looks out for his children, even if they don't think they need it.
walking on the water, even when I could not see. In the middle of it all, I thought you were a thousand miles away. Not for a moment did you forsake me. Not for a moment did you forsake me. After all, you are constant. After
her. She's going to die.
Poor be with that truck driver. I'm sure it was an accident.
Lord, I'm sure he's very devastated.
Hey, I just got word from the emergency room.
Please tell Sydney
No, she must be okay.
She's gone.
No, you're lying. She's okay.
They said the impact was too much for her body to handle. She's dead.
I was just with her this morning.
Me too. She was dropping me off and I was going home, and then I don't know if the truck didn't see her, if she didn't see the truck.
I can't believe this. She's one of my best friends. Look, she texted me this morning.
To everyone who's lost someone they love, long before it was their time. You feel like the days you had were not enough when you said goodbye. And to all of the people with burdens and pains, keeping you back from your life. You believe that there's nothing and there is no one who can make it right. And there is hope for the helpless, rest for the weary, and love for the broken heart. And there is grace and forgiveness, mercy and healing. He'll meet you wherever you are. Cry.
Girls, I'm sorry for your loss and everything that you're going through. And I think that God just has something very special to say to you this morning. And to be honest, I think everybody too. You see, Jesus had disciples, right? You know this. And these disciples, they assumed that they could probably rescue Jesus. In his time of need, they thought they could probably free him and they would escape, that he wouldn't be crucified. And then all of a sudden, he is crucified. He's up on a tree and he's killed. And they're mourning and they're sad and they have no clue what is going on and they feel like all hope is lost. And just like you guys are feeling right now, losing a very, very good friend, you know that hopeless feeling, knowing that she'll never be here in this life ever again. But what I want to share with you guys is this hope, this amazing hope, and the reason of why we need Jesus so much is because he gives us hope. Your friend died, but I don't want you to be sad because she is in heaven. Giving her life to Jesus Christ, that gives her salvation and gives her an eternity without pain, without worry, without anxiety, but pure joy and awesomeness. Hope. That's, we need him because of hope. He gives us hope. And you guys hope too. I mean, you can know that you'll see her once again, that you'll see everyone that dies once again because of this incredible hope that you have in Jesus, that he did rise. He came back to life. If he just died, then that would just end it, and we would be not doing this. This would be pointless. But he had to come back to life 100% and ascend into heaven so that we can have salvation and a hope that is incredible. Let me pray for us. God, I know that everything that we go through can seem hopeless, can seem out of shape and seem crazy and frustrating, and we feel like we can't go on when things happen that are nuts. And God, thank you so much. Jesus, thank you so much for coming to this world, this dying, decaying world, decrepit world full of sin. Thank you for coming to this world dying, but most of all, thank you for rising, coming back to life to give us salvation, to give us hope, to give us joy. Thank you for that. And give us peace of mind knowing that everybody that we know that has died, that they're they're at peace with Christ, that they're full of joy. Thank you for everything you've done. We love you. In your name we pray. Amen.
Lord, I can't believe Cindy is gone. We even had plans for this weekend. Lord, I want to trust in you. Pastor Nate talked about a future hope, but are you real? Do you even know how hard this is? I want to know that you're here now, not in 1,000 years. Please, Lord, please.
Sally, wake up. Wake up, it's me, Cindy.
Cindy, is that you? Are you okay?
It's me. I'm in heaven.
I must be dreaming.
Yes, it's real. It's the most beautiful place I've ever seen.
I must be dreaming.
No, you're not dreaming. He's real, too.
Who?
Jesus. He met me here, and he showed me my home.
Jesus?
Yes, I've seen him. He is alive.
Then it's true.
It's all true. Sally, tell everyone that Jesus is alive. He has room for everyone. He's alive.
Jesus is alive? Jesus is alive.
Is closing in on the inside, but I'm not showing it. When all I am is crying out, I hold it in and fake a smile. I'm broken. I'm broken. Only one can understand, and only one can hold the hand. Stretched hands.
Such an incredible Savior, or such a valuable price, or such a death-defying miracle, or such amazing grace, such an eternal hope, or such a perfect plan, but in Christ Jesus our Lord. Is that true?
Amen.
Don't seek those things that are dead, but seek those things that are alive. Put your heart, your trust, your confidence, your hope in Him. Because Jesus is alive today.
Amen.
Amen? Amen. Amen. Lord, thanks for time together today. For these young people that tried their best to pour out, Lord, the understanding that you're alive. And that in every circumstance, in the girls and in the cars and the crazy life of youth these days, that they can find you in the middle of it all. And in the very end, that's all that sustains and that's all that matters. Thank you, Lord, that you came. You lived, you died, you rose again for us. Thank you, Lord. Forever give you praise. We long, Lord, to search and follow and run after you all of our life and find that Savior who loved us enough to die, who lives. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise today and forever in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thanks for coming, everybody.